Back at Gillette Stadium for day two of Patriots padded practice. I'm Sierra Goodwill here with Evan Lazar. One question heading into this camp is who's going to replace Marcus Cannon at right tackle. There's really two guys duking it out at this point. I want you to break them down individually. Let's start with Yadni Kajust. Has he been impressive so far?
Kajust is swimming a little bit right now. You know, I think that he's basically a rookie at this point. He had the mental reps last year, certainly got in the playbook a little bit. But now we're out on the field, and I think it's a completely different animal. He's taking a lot of coaching. He hasn't looked particularly great so far, but it's only two padded practices, and these are his first two NFL practices so far. I think the biggest thing that you see with him is leverage points, the ability to get underneath guys, drive them off the ball, get his hands inside the shoulder pads, and really be able to use his force. You know, he's a really strong guy, but if you're not able to leverage a block, then you're not going to be able to be the low man. You know, low man always wins, as they say. If you can't do that, then you're not really going to move too many guys off the ball. He's looked okay in pass protection. They did some two-on-twos today with the tackles and the guards. They haven't done any one-on-one reps. It's one thing about Patriots camp that's different than other camps. They don't have time for that one-on-one stuff. You know, you want to go out there and do one-on-ones with DBs and wide receivers. That's not what we're about here. So we haven't really seen Kajust on an island pass protect like that so far, but he hasn't necessarily done a bad job there from what I've seen. It's mainly just, you know, leveraging his blocks, leveraging his gaps, and understanding body positioning and pad level and hand placement and all the technical things that he wasn't able to work on during his rookie season because he was on injured reserve.
The other guy kind of duking it out for that Cannon role at right tackle, Jermaine Elsminore. What have you seen from him so far to make this kind of a bit of a competition?
Well, Elsminore has taken the lion's share of the snaps at right tackle so far, and I think the biggest thing that you see with him, and I know, you know, it's funny because with offensive line play, a lot of the time when you have four good starters like the Patriots do, just don't sink the ship, right? Just don't be the anchor of the offensive line. And so far, Elsminore hasn't been the anchor, right? It hasn't been like that group gets in there and there's this giant void at right tackle. So he's been serviceable at that position. He's definitely more of a guard body type than he is a tackle body type. And I worry about his ability to, you know, get to his set points and avoid getting beat around the corner by fast pass rushers. But as a run blocker, he's got some strength to him. He's got some girth. He can definitely push guys off the ball. And you look at what Marcus Cannon used to do, that's a similar skill set. You know, a guy that's built more like a guard that they played at right tackle so that they could get that push off the line of scrimmage. I think Elsminore can do similar things. We'll see how he holds up in pass protection, but mainly that anchor, that strength in his upper body. He has all those types of things that they had with Cannon.
Well, we'll continue to update you from Patriots training camp practice on our website at clnsmedia.com and over on our YouTube channel at Patriots Press Pass.
Patriots Training Camp Central is brought to you by Manscaped. Get 20% off and free shipping with the code MAXWELL20 at manscaped.com. Take your grooming game to the next level.